Like, and he bigged you up crazy. He's like, man, when I was on death row, I wasn't even making money. We was pretty much getting our allowance. He was like, when I went to P, we turned into a bosses. Yeah. He was like, he turned me to a boss. He gave me money. He taught me the business.
Yeah.
He's like, man, Master P, man, is really the one who set things up for me. So what was it like working with Snoop? And I want to know, did you influence the sound on that song, Top Dollar, with the gold flea cock? Because it was a whole different sound from Snoop.
Yeah, now that's what we'll do. We'll get in the studio and we'll just come up. And we'll work together.
Yeah.
And so that's No Limit is a family, man. I feel like we're a university. I told Snoop, everybody around, when it's time to graduate, I want y'all to go on and do what y'all need to do. Like, I want him to be his own boss. I want him to be a millionaire, billionaire, whatever it is. So when Snoop came to No Limit, I realized he had so much left in the tank.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he just, people thought his career was over.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm like, man, we love Snoop. Like, Snoop is a star.
Yeah.
I just need to show him that, man, you need to go out and go do what you got to do.
Yeah.
I kind of like got that from, I read about this guy who owned this book, and y'all probably know him, is Dr. Seuss.
Yeah.
So the guy was throwing his books away. He was got tired. His career was over. He felt like nobody believed in him.
Mm-hmm.
But his friend was on the side, said, man, what you doing? He was throwing his books in the garbage can. He said, I'm done with writing books.
Yeah.
So his friend grabbed and said, no, man, I know a publisher. Let's take these books over there. And he ended up being one of the biggest writers for kids' books in the world. So I just was that guy to tell Snoop, it's not over, man. Like, you the best, dog. Like, you really need to go. It just focus on you.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what he did. And I mean, I always looked at him as a boss.
Yeah.
Because I looked up to him for his music. You know, and I'm like, no, man, you need to be owning this.
Yeah.
You need to be putting out groups. You need to be doing all these things. Like, you put too much time in this business. Like, you're a legend. You're a star. And by us coming together, he was able to be more committed.
Yeah.
And also, he was more into who he is as a boss than just an artist.
Hell yeah.
You know, and I think he ended up started those groups he had at the time. And
that East Side, that whole movement.
And that's what, I could have had a piece of that.
Yeah.
Say, nah, I didn't want it, man. Do your thing.
Yep. Let him get his bread.
Yeah. Nah,
Pandora, Spotify, girl, I came to satisfy, but the panties to the side, I can exercise.
I can't afford to lend you more when you were stealing honey buns, my nigga, we was still a stove. Anybody turn the hoe, they usually the first to go. I got a wife.
Whatever doing, so like, whatever, holes is a bunch of me doing that type of shit. It's being better than you, nigga, whoever watching.
The crack is sucking dick for cash and EBT, and no limit on the trees, so I'm trying to master peas, and I've been a hot boy. Putting fall on my teacup, a bandana around my dorm and read my classes.
Compare me to JD. Compare me to JD. It's like the NBA to JB. I'm from the dirty south. Get that Kanye West and send it to the Davies. I'm a doctor with the pond. The pond loud like some Drake beats. Disrespect, your whole team will take naps. I don't brush it off. I'm KD.
This episode is also sponsored by Famous Cuts Barbershop, located in Phoenix, Arizona, on 79th Avenue and Thomas Road. Fades, beards, tapers, and shaves. Famous Cuts accepts walk-ins and appointments. Available at famouscuts.setmore.com. That's Cuts, C-U-T-Z, with a Z. Committed and passionate barbers, always accepting new clients. Family owned and operated. Go check it out.